जय श्रील प्रभुपाद, हरे कृष्णा नाम प्रभु की जय। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द समरी सेशंस ऑफ सोलफुल जपा। द लास्ट सेशन वी डिस्कस सम वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टेटमेंट्स दैट कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ मेड अबाउट हिज नामा। And I quoted 5 verses, and these were from Hari Bhakti Vilas, originally from Adi Purana. So it was wonderful to get introduced to the person to whom we want a relationship, our Nama Prabhu. His introduction is given by Krishna himself. So that is how, you know, we have been chanting for quite a long time the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, but now we have a formal introduction from the scriptures. We have been hearing a lot about Lord Krishna, but what about Krishna's name that we heard? Very mercifully, Sanatana Goswami has collected all these quotes from different scriptures, and it is a great wealth for us to know what Krishna himself thinks about his name. So today I will continue 2 more verses where, in that same sequence, where Krishna concludes that. After that, I'll give a few other very important introduction to Nama, the glories of Nama, from different scriptures given by Sanatana Goswami in the same text, Hari Bhakti Vilas. So we will go through that today, and then we will talk about some part of something about faith also. So after Krishna has explained yesterday about the 5 verses, which, how are we connected to that japa? As I said, the first round is Sevak Bhavan round. That means it's an anchoring of your Sevak ego. Nama Sevak ego. And for the Nama Sevak ego, means it is a relationship ego, your relationship ego with Nama Prabhu. For that, you have to know who is Nama Prabhu, what is Nama Prabhu, what is your connection with Nama Prabhu, everything you have to know. Therefore, we are in this particular absolute thoughts of the holy name and our connection with the holy name, and you know, the glories of the holy name, what we benefit by chanting the holy name. These are the things that we are trying to, you know, create a body of absolute knowledge, which we can convert into a feeling of being his sevak. Being his sevak, knowing the glories of it, and seeking a relationship of service by chanting, concurrent chanting and hearing. So that is the first mala we are talking about. As I said yesterday also, day for yesterday, that both these first mala, which is called the anchoring round, and the Shraddha round, more or less things overlap, quite a lot of it overlap. So let us see today the next verse from Hari Bhakti Vilas, where this conversation between Arjuna and Krishna is concluded. So now Lord Krishna further explains. The person who feels happy when he sees others chant my holy name goes to the supreme abode and enjoys with Lord Vishnu. So please remember this. Next verse is Tasman Namani Kaunteya Bhajasva Dhrida Manasaha Nama Yukta Priyo Asmaka Asmakam Nama Yukta Bhavarjuna. For these reasons, Arjuna, you should worship my holy names, chant my holy names, and become friends with they who chant my names. So just see, Krishna himself is telling Arjuna, you should worship my holy name, chant my holy names, and become friends with they who chant my names.
This is amazing.
Krishna says,
He purchases me also my name.
There is no other price
to purchase me.
Next,
Evam Shutva Cha Mama Namani.
The Lord says,
He purchases me.
Who hears my name?
So just see.
So he purchases me also.
Now here I want to comment something
very important.
Those who are wanted, one can chant, one can visit. But here what I say, he purchases me also my name.
Just call out his name, he testifies.
You feel personal, you can call out the name of the person, you don't love, call out, that's an address.
To Krishna and Sri Krishna, an address to the Lord. So, there's slight difference between chanting and calling out. Chanting becomes calling out when there is Shraddha, that the Lord is a person, that the Nama is a personality, Nama Prabhu is being called. Then his name is equal to calling. You uttering name is equal to calling. So therefore, this is very important. Small difference comes between chanting and calling. You have to be personal to call. That means Namina, the owner of the name has to be remembered if it is calling. If it is chanting, only chanting, not calling, it is also possible. Repetition of the name. You are not feeling you are calling the Lord. Now in Soulful Japa, we have developed everything in a way in which chanting is welcoming the Lord to descend on tongue. Hearing is associating with the Lord. And it becomes very, very pleasant if chanting becomes calling. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. You have to become personal if you have to call. So anyway, so next is Evam Shutva Cham
Mama Namani Ityadi. Same thing Krishna says, if someone hears my names, he purchases me. Hearing his name means he should hear for his, oh, this is Krishna's name. So wonderful. Delightfully. If you see our delightful round, Drishtam. Same thing. Hrishtam and Aghladam. The two rounds that we are talking about, I think it is the fifth and sixth round. The fifth round is about calling. You cannot delightfully chant unless you are calling him. And you cannot delightfully hear his name as his name if you're delightfully calling, it has to be with Priti. So therefore, after that, it's a Priti round. And then we have delightfully chanting, again to connect. First round is the anchoring round. Second round is the Shraddha round. Third round is divine dependency. Fourth round is begging. Third round is gratitude. Fourth round is divine dependency on Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Fifth round is begging forgiveness for offenses. Sixth round is taking delight in chanting. Sixth round is taking delight and joy in hearing. And seventh round is
very lovingly chanting, come hearing, chanting, come hearing. So these are the that's why I said these are all interconnected. Anyway, now I want to repeatedly remind in each session everyone that no, don't get lost in bhavanas now. Bhavanas are meant for pre-japa work, off-japa time chintan or contemplation. Just because every day we are talking about this bhavana, don't forget your foreground. That's the most important thing. Chanting, come hearing, chanting, come hearing, chanting, come hearing. Okay, so don't forget that. In fact, I've been thinking those cue cards I should change a bit. Everywhere I should repeat, the top most important thing is first concurrent chanting and hearing. Otherwise, you see the cue card, your whole japa becomes only bhavana japa and you are only contemplating and you are not actually hearing the chantings. That precaution, you know, I'm trying to do it very fast, therefore I had to do it. Otherwise, patiently I should have waited full 90 days for you to go on, become expert in the chanting come hearing concurrently on each concurrently occurring manifesting nama, chant and hear, give kriya chesta, jnana chesta, learn that completely. So any of this discussion about bhavana, though in conclusion I am giving a 16 cue cards, everywhere below the cue card I am writing what is the foreground activity, what is the background activity. So don't get slowly, you know, convert your japa into a contemplation session. And that's also devotional service. As I told you, it is not offensive. But what you need during that, you can do other time also. But japa time, you please learn how to concurrently chant and hear. Your foreground mind should not be taken away for contemplation. Moment it is not a bhavana. If it is only a bhavana, then it's not. If the bhavana is applied directly on the nama who is appearing, you don't have to worry. This worry is only because the thoughts have not been cooked fully into a bhavana, and therefore, you know, you get into contemplation during japa. So caution, every time I am cautioning that all the effort that we have put to bring about the importance of chanting come hearing each nama that appears, that never changes in any bhavana. That manifests the Lord before us. Before you give feelings to somebody, he should be before you. Is it not?
So you bring him before you by concurrent chanting, come hearing. And then in the present, online, you are giving these feelings. Feelings of dependency, feelings of shraddha, feelings of, gratitude, feelings of all the different bhavanas that I have, the cue cards that I have given.
So this is a science. Huh? Don't do mistakes. In fact, this contemplation is a very... pleasant experience for the mind. Think of Krishna's glories and Krishna's, all those things. So what happens is you instead of hearing, you go into that and you start enjoying that, relishing that. And practically the japa goes into auto mode. You are not conscious of hearing. Yeah, very fine point I am telling. Don't miss this point. All your success depends upon chanting come hearing, because this is the path in Kali Yuga. Potency is in there. I will show you one quote. Even Lord Shiva is telling. Even just simply you hear his nama. Lord Shiva himself is telling Parvati. Not that Prabhupada has created something from somewhere. I have dedicated one module to explain. Should we think of Krishna's pastime during japa? And that module is also there. You can read that module. That is somewhere around between 54 or 55. Module 54 or 55. So go to the next quote. In Vishnu Dharma Purana, Prahlad Maharaja says, he is conquered three times. Lord Krishna is conquered by one who keeps the two syllables Hari, Ha and Ri on the tip of his tongue. Just see, these are all facts. The Supreme Lord is conquered, no doubt. If you always keep Hari, 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 Hari. In our case, Hari, Krishna, 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 Hari, 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 Ram, Hari, Ram, 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 Hari, Hari. He's conquered. Whole day you can chant. Please have faith in everything that is being spoken here. You may not be able to experience some things. Does not mean that it is not true. I have given you so many things. So many examples. Just like you have a gloves in your hand. You keep on a hot plate. The hot plate is there. It is a fact. But you will not be experienced because of the gloves. Rubber gloves. Insulator. So similarly, our material energy is insulating us from realizing the benefit of how the Lord is indebted to the devotee. That means he's conquered. It is not a small thing. First of all, for the holy name to appear on the tongue of the devotees. It appears on the tongue of the devotees only by the will of the Lord. Okay. So all these are not exaggeration at all. Next. In Vishnu Chintamani, Lord Shiva tells Goddess Uma, with a great struggle, it is possible to meditate on Lord Krishna. He is talking about meditation. However, simply by moving the lips, one can easily chant Lord Krishna's holy name. For this reason, the chanting Lord's name, chanting of the Lord's name is more effective than trying to meditate on Him. So you got this another big secret. Unless you pick up from Prabhupada's quote, these things are not very obvious. Huh? One can think that what is wrong when I am chanting? I'll think of Krishna lifting over the hill. I'll think of Krishna's this, Krishna's pastime. I'll think of Krishna's pastime with the gopis. You're not following exactly what the Guru says. You want pakka results, you have to do what the Guru says. Okay, next. In both Garuda Purana and Padma Purana, it is said, for a person bitten by snake of repeated birth and death, the word Krishna is a perfect medicine. When one hears the Krishna mantra, he becomes cured at once. So such is the powerful Shabda. Is so powerful, that word is. It's an absolute Shabda. That is a perfect medicine that to finish birth and death. That means for liberation. Next. Prabhase Purane. I am not reading the Sanskrit. It is right there. It is right there. In the Prabhasa Purana, during a conversation between Narada and Kushadvaja, the Supreme Personality of Godhead explains, O powerful one, most important name is Krishna. This name is the atonement for sins and the supreme grantor of liberation. Of course, we are all suffering in this material world, and freedom from material miseries, freedom from material energy, which covers us from Krishna, is very much desired by the devotees. So, in that sense, liberation as freedom from ignorance is also desired by devotees, but not in terms of, you know, one of the four liberations of going Sarupya, Salokya, Samipya, Sayujya, all those muktis. The devotee who is, at least in this parampara, do not desire any of those liberations. The devotee, our parampara, wants to gift us the pure, supreme Krishna prema, love of Krishna. That is a specific gift that this parampara wants to give. Okay. So, next. In Dwaraka Mahatmya, a conversation of Prahlad and Bali, it is said, in Kali Yuga, the person who chants the holy name Krishna delivers 7 generations of ancestors and 14 generations of descendants. You see, this is the power. Not only you benefit, but 14 generations of future descendants and 7 generations of ancestors, wherever their life is now, suddenly they will enjoy the benefit of liberation. The benefit will go there. What to speak of father and mother of the devotees who dedicate their lives? So many youngsters have joined Srila Prabhupada's movement in 1966. Their home, everything they gave up, and they chanted. And so many, nowadays, so many Indian boys and girls are joining this Krishna consciousness movement by dedicating their lives for preaching Krishna consciousness, dedicating their lives for chanting the holy names of the Lord. That is why one of the first offenses is what? The blasphemed devotees who have dedicated their lives for spreading the holy name. Does not matter what shade of faith and all those things, whether it is a Ritvik or non-Ritvik, all these things are not, it's immaterial. If he is chanting the holy name of the Lord, one should not blaspheme such a person who is chanting the holy name of the Lord. Okay. You know, within the Vaishnava etiquette, we may argue, we may discuss, we may do all those things. But in your heart, you should not blaspheme, because you see how rare it is, persons who chant Hare Krishna. To call them demons, all those things, we have to be very, very careful about that. No doubt, sometimes there will be rare demons in the dress of Vaishnava. That is different. Even if there is a demon in the dress of Vaishnava, if he is chanting Hare Krishna, you will get so much benefit ultimately. Even demons got, all demons that Krishna killed also got liberation. So the ways of the world, the ways of Maya are you know, multiple and inconceivable for us. But we have to be very careful that anybody who chants Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is blessed. Anybody who chants Lord's name is blessed. Anybody, human, even one who teases, what is this Hare Krishna, like this, you see sometimes people make a joke. What is this Hare Krishna, I mean, that too, he raised his hand and he said Hare Krishna, but he's teasing. So much benefit he will get. Next. So, devotees who give their lives to preach Krishna consciousness, for them to seven generations passed, so they say, no, you are not doing your duty to your father and mother. Hey, what is duty to father and mother? You, one life, you are gone. All your karma is gone. You get liberated. If you have any material desires, my dear father and mother, Krishna will take you through so many lives and still he will give you liberation in the end. He'll fulfill all your desires. Why you are struggling in this body? Get a good life. So anybody who dedicates his life for Krishna consciousness movement is doing the highest welfare activity to his family, his ancestors, and their soul. You need faith. And go by what you, if I have saved myself, let me save everybody else also in my family members. Instead of the family members, they don't understand the significance of the devotee dedicating his life to spread the holy name of the Lord. And they try to take him, because they are ignorant, they try to, due to attachment, they try to bring him back into the world of karma. In Narasimha Purana, Supreme Personality of Godhead declares, as a growing lotus flower breaks through the water, so I pull up from hell a person who chanting Krishna, Krishna always remembers me. Just see. As I told you in the beginning of a Japa module, I told you Krishna Nama's Leela, Nama Prabhu's Leela, is to pull out the living entities from this hellish material life and take them back to Godhead. Such is the, you know, gift of Nama Prabhu. So that's next. Next. In the Narada Purana, Narada Muni explains, by hearing Lord Krishna's names, even great sinners become purified. How can a fool like me properly glorify the Lord's holy names? See, so glorious is the Lord's holy name. It requires little thinking. The glories are unbelievable. I mean, can just this one sound, Nama of the Lord uttering, can give these all these benefits? It gives. Next. All the names of the Supreme Personality of Godhead are equally glorious. However, the names of Lord Krishna are especially glorious. Next. These are all quotes from different scriptures. Lord Krishna's holy name extends a hand to save the conditioned souls fallen in the ocean of birth and death. No one is expert like the holy name. So, just see. What did I say? Nama Leela? In module 1 and module 2, the Lord has incarnated Kalikale Nama Rupa, Krishna Avatara is incarnated and is incarnated in the form of the Hare Krishna movement. That's what Srila Prabhupada says. And those and incarnated for what purpose? It says here, no one is expert like holy name. You have to be expert. If somebody is stuck in this material world, to take him out, you have to be expert. Guru and Krishna, Nama, together, they work on the heart of the chitta of the living entity who is surrendered to them and who follows their instruction. By Divya Gyan Hriday Prakashita, step by step, one by one, the ignorance is removed and the Krishna consciousness of the devotee is awakened. Today my ignorance is at one level about something. Just like you see in your first standard, you are ignorant about A, B, C, D. Then when you are in fifth standard, A, B, C, D is all normal for you. You can read and write. At fifth standard, you have got some other ignorance. So there is a personalized teacher. Okay, you are class 5 students. I will teach you class 6 lessons. Somebody is class 1. I will teach you. He cannot give you class 7 lesson. That means there has to be personalized picking up of the devotee and making him elevate in his consciousness, removing anarthas one by one, enlightening him with chitta shakti. The nama is an ocean of satchit ananda. So that chit is there, chitta shakti is there. That chit satta chitta shakti flows into the living entity's heart. It is like a torchlight of knowledge, satchit shakti. It shines into our chit. Our chit is full of ignorance now. So it's all cleared. Not simply step by step you have to clear, because we have used our free will, and we have come into this world using our free will. We have to go back out of this world only using our free will. Nobody is forcing us to go back. And this is the reason the delay happens of the living entity in achieving his full bhakti. The delay is his own free will. So that important is our free will. If we are very active with our free will to respond to what the way Guru and Krishna wants us to move forward day after day, through soulful japa, through self-control, through good Vaishnava achar, behavior, all these things, you will see that quickly we can make progress in Krishna consciousness. The delay in advancing in Krishna consciousness is our delay. Yeah. So Lord Krishna, holy name, is expert in picking up each devotee from where he is, step up. Just imagine how much you feel obligated. The Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu on my tongue, he is very personal to me. And Prabhupada has given you that Nama Prabhu to serve. You serve him and then you get reciprocation of self-purification and awakening of Krishna consciousness. Next. In Jabali Samhita, it is said, a person who desires real happiness should again and again sing, remember, glorify and chant on japa beads the holy names of Lord Krishna. Next. In Itihasa Uttama, it is said, a person who is in dream somehow remembers Lord Krishna's holy names, destroys multitudes of sins. What then is the fate of one who carefully chants Lord Krishna's holy names? So to summarize, how fortunate we are. This is not an ordinary thing that has come into our lives. The holy name has come into our life, our ability to chant on 16 rounds. This is a super, 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 super blessings that we have received. In millions of lives, we cannot get once more if we miss this chance. We have to become attached to this process of chanting, come hearing, and then receive the greatest benediction of Krishna Prema, Krishna consciousness. Within one lifetime it is possible, because that is why it said one lifetime it is possible if we chant and hear properly. So soulful japa is another thing. So many glories of the Nama Japa is we have heard. One thing I want to caution you, if somebody has started chanting inattentively, don't criticize him. That is his stage. Sometimes you also chant. Don't criticize him. Encourage him. And you should also perceive it in a way. This is a stage. It doesn't matter. Now, you are blessed to get this soulful japa. Now, you also should not think, oh, this is so much. Prabhu has given 108 modules. it looks like very difficult, you know, japa or serving the holy name is very difficult. Don't say like that. Even one utterance of holy name is so much beneficial. Do you want to go to college? Do you want to go to graduation? Do you want to go to post graduation? Not that, you know, the school of chanting holy name is very easy. Mindlessly also you chant, you're in the school. Now, just because you are in the college, you are in graduation, post-graduation, you don't look at the school student and laugh. What is it here? You should do graduation. No, it has to come. Slowly he has to come. Right? It's all, Nama Prabhu is in control. Those who are ready only will come and get the benefit of their mind will allow them to hear the soulful japa sessions. So practice soulful, to read soulful japa. If they are not ready, it will stop them. So you don't worry about it. So for everybody, Lord has, the holy name has manifested. This is one of the reasons why Prabhupada is not for general preaching. He has not told everybody you should do soulful japa. He generally said you chant and hear offenselessly. You chant with faith and devotion. You chant with preeti. Now, according to your realizations, you can practice. 16 rounds. Like once Prabhupada said, what is quality of chanting? Prabhupada said, quality or no quality, first quantity, chant 16 rounds. Follow the Guru's instruction. That is the bhavana, first bhavana. So therefore, we should understand the place of soulful japa. We are trying to do nothing wrong. If I get attached to holy name, I want to serve him very nicely. Can anybody stop? Sat bhavana japa. If you have the inspiration to do it, if you are lazy, it is all right. I will just do my 16 rounds, I will do one, like a ritual and I will complete it. No problem, you get stuck there. Nama Prabhu will put you out of that some other time. Because in any case, if you do ritualistic japa, there will be some offenses because bhavana is not there. So therefore, even in mindful chanting, bhavana of obedience is a must. Even if not, no other thing, simply out of, I promised my guru 16 rounds and offer that 16 rounds to him, to guru. Whatever offenses are there, all those things will get neutralized. I hope you know, I want to make this clarification earlier also, that if the shoe fits you, you get into it. If the soulful japa modules appeals to you, it excites you to become closer to the Nama and to experience deeper relationship with Nama Prabhu, get into it. Okay? No pains, no gains. Now, let us go to the Mala 2, faith. I have already given 16 points, which is earlier. I think four sessions before this, I began the Shraddha. Now, that Shraddha is basically about, you know, holy name is non-different from Krishna. Holy name is the brilliant son of Satchidananda. So, it's all about the holy name. How the holy name, Nama Prabhu, how Nama Prabhu empowers the Nama on your tongue to become Shakti Avasya Nama, and how we become purified. All those things is about the holy name. But your holy faith in the holy name as equal to Krishna, fine. But before that, something else is required. You have to have faith in Krishna himself, no? Yes. What are those faiths? This faith in his existence. I mean, if you are a Mayavadi, if you are an impersonalist, say these are all imaginations in Purana. There is no Krishna or Rama or anything. That is faithlessness. Such a person, no chanting is chanting. What is, why should he chant? No inspiration. If he doesn't believe in the existence of the Lord. So the Lord is eternal person, the cause of all causes. And one should have faith in his unconditional love. The Lord is so, he's so great. As well as Brahman, Parabrahman, so great that this tiny Brahman, small particle of his, towards that tiny particle, the Lord shows unconditional love. This entire material creation itself is a manifestation of his unconditional respect for the living entity. His love for the living entity to that degree that if you don't love me also, chalo. Go ahead. Live your own life and existence of karma. Laws of karma is there. Now you earn yourself. You want to be on your own. Isn't that a matter of unconditional love? Even material creation is a manifestation of his unconditional love. Love for our free will. I'll respect you. When you respect somebody, that's before love comes respect. There cannot be love without respect. There is no other philosophy like Krishna consciousness, where it is declared that God respects every living entity. My God, respect means respecting people's free will. Because free will is the greatest gift of consciousness. Free will is the greatest gift of consciousness. Somebody will say, God should not have given this free will. Why I am suffering because of all this free will? It's just like saying that, you know, if there's cataract in the eyes, the solution is to remove the cataract and see the beautiful things. And free yourself from suffering blindness, suffering of blindness. Instead, some foolish fellow will say, why God gave this eyes? Let's pluck this eyes out. I don't understand why God created this eyes. Because he created eyes, I got cataract. Because God has given me free will, I am suffering. Are you the greatest? Your misuse of free will, little misuse of free will is what you are facing the consequences. But the gift of free will is unlimited. There is no question of love without free will. There is no question of loving devotional service. The spiritual world is full of love. It's full of lovingly, freely one is engaging in service of the Lord, is trying to please the Lord. That is the spiritual world, full of that. So therefore, our free will is very important. And our spiritual master teaches how to train our free will. Do's and don'ts. Yama and Niyama. No intoxication, no meat eating, no illicit, no gambling, and do chanting, devotion service, etc. At a big level, macro level, these instructions are there. Then there are finer instructions. So every instruction that Guru has given us is actually activating our spiritual free will. In other words, today if you're following four regulative principles, it is nothing, you are thinking that I am suppressing myself. No, but actually you are liberating your soul towards true freedom. Liberation from Maya is true freedom. So, faith in his unconditional love. Faith in his fairness and equality. See, first, now we are talking about Krishna. And then Krishna's name is Krishna. So unless you know about Krishna, you hear about Krishna, when you get the equation Krishna is Krishna's name, then when you chant Krishna's name, all these things also should also come. Otherwise it won't come. Bhavana. So Shraddha means not only particularly Krishna is Krishna's name. Shraddha is about Krishna himself. And then you get excited. Oh my God, this Krishna is right on my tongue and he's same as that. There is no difference. Abhinnatva nama naminoho. Non-different. Then faith in his fairness and equality. This also, this by reading Srila Prabhupada's book, you understand all these things. It is not God is cruel to somebody, is this thing to somebody. No, it's all play of freedom. Prabhupada, Krishna has given us the freedom. Faith in his friendship. If you're a devotee, you should have faith in his friendship. Just like Arjuna had faith in his friendship to the Lord. Suhurdam sarvabhutanam, Krishna declares in the Bhagavad Gita. From that statement, from that absolute thought, by contemplation, you develop faith in his friendship. Faith in his omnipotency. Faith in his supremacy. There's nobody equal to or greater than him. You should believe that. If you don't have faith, if you think Krishna is same, Ganesha is same, Kali is same, everybody is same, then you're not going according to what the scripture says. It's not that, okay, Prabhupada likes Krishna, so this is Krishna consciousness movement. Somebody else likes Kali, so that is the... All are God. All are God. One and the same. Aparadha, number 2, out of 10 offenses in Padma Purana itself says, those 10 offenses are from where? From Padma Purana. Don't equate Vishnu with other demigods. Vishnu is Vishnu, is transcendental. Even Shankaracharya, the impersonalist, also in his commentary on Vishnu Sahasranama, when it comes to Narayana, he says, he declares Narayana as Paravyakta. His transcendental personality, Narayana. Other demigods are like me and you. Only a highly facilitated, highly advanced body. But all are trapped in a body, in a robot. From jiva, from animal, from insect, from worm, up to devatas. They are all entrapped in a material body of material energy, which is different from the spirit who is residing inside. So nobody can equalize Vishnu with the demigods. In this material world, Vishnu is there as a maintainer. He is transcendental. He is never born. You read Bhagavatam, Brahma is born, Shiva is born in the process. But Vishnu? No. Mahavishnu lying on the Karnajula expands so many, brings out so many Brahmandas out, and in each Brahmanda he goes and lies down in the water of that bottom of the Brahmanda as the Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. And as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, from his navel, Padmanabha sprouts a lotus, and on that lotus, Brahma is created, etc., etc. And after that, he expands into each jiva and each atom as Shirodakshaya Vishnu, as Paramatma, Super Soul. So there is no birth for him. Like Prabhupada says different times, though Lakshmi is at his feet, In order to create, he doesn't need Lakshmi. In the material world, you need man and woman to create life. He is simply the father of all living entities. That's all. Aham Bija Pradyapati. Faith in his friendship, faith. Next. Faith in his supremacy. There's nobody equal to or greater than Krishna. Where? How do you get? Go read this. Bhagavad Gita is a source of faith. All faith. That's why Bhagavad Gita, if you understand properly, if you read it several times, or if simply you believe in what Krishna declares in Bhagavad Gita, you have got the necessary faith. That is, it's a book of faith, Bhagavad Gita. It is not for twisting some meanings out of it. Management meanings and this and that and mind control meanings and all those things. It is a book of faith. Faith that the entire existence is for his purpose. Faith that the entire existence comes from him. Aham sarvasya prabho mata sarvam pravartate. You see, the faith that entire existence is for his purpose is very important. You see, We all think that, you know, world exists for me. At least all our activities are based around that. Okay, world is there, I have to take out everything, what I need. You exist. Everybody exists. This world exists. This cosmos exists for his personal purpose. We think the cosmos exists for my purpose. No. His purpose of giving an opportunity for living entity to exercise his free will and freely come to him one day, that is the purpose of this material world. Out of love, come to him. So ultimately, whose purpose it is? It is his purpose. Faith that if you become his devotee, he will take you to him. Then, where do I get that? Krishna told this. Manmana bhavantu madhyaji mam namaskuru mamayveshi satyante pratijnana priyosime. I have faith, Krishna. You have done. Pratijna, you have done. I have faith. If I think of you, I will come to you. Faith that the entire existence is his estate. Yes. He is a, you know, if you read Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you get this. Aham sarvasya prabhu mato sarvam prabhu. Mayadekshene suyete sacharacharam. Everything moving, non-moving, everything is under my superintendence. I am supervising all these things at a macro level. Faith that he is a source of power for both demons and demigods. Today, if I am speaking, that this power is coming from the super soul. To speak nonsense also, power is coming from the super soul. To speak about him is also coming from the super soul. Because we as a living entity cannot control matter, cannot move matter. We are spirit. This is matter. But for God, there is no spirit and matter. Everything he can move. So without super soul's permission, without his sanction, not a blade of grass will move in this material world. We are thinking, I am the doer, I am the mover and all these things. But Krishna is the one who does it and makes us feel, okay, you think you are having a life. But Krishna is the one who is creating the life of a devotee, life of a non-devotee. Means creating that possibility of that experience for you as per your desire. Simply desire is not enough. Material energy has to move according to that desire. That moving is by the sanction of the Supreme Lord. Faith in the protection of his devotees. Next. Faith that if you can become conscious of him by intervention or by his intervention, all difficulties in life can be overcome. The faith, devotee is always having faith because life is about material world means padam padam yadvi padam, full of difficulties. Full of difficulties. Is it not? Always we want to try to solve difficulties. Living entities are always praying to demigods. Everybody, give me that, give me this, this problem, that problem, all these things. Devotees are no exemption. They also have a material body, they have all these problems. Right? But they simply become conscious of the Lord. Machitta sarodurgani matprasadat tarishyasi. Oh, by his matprasadat, by my mercy, you will have faith in the statement of Krishna. What does he say? Machitta sarodurgani. Before that he says, chetasa sarvakarmani mai sanyasya matparaha. Chetasa sarvakarmani. All your activities do in my consciousness. Chetasa sarvakarmani mai sanyasya matparaha. Surrender those works unto me. Do it as a servant. Krishna is not disconnected from anything, even making a nut and bolt in a lathe. If you remember Krishna, not that it gets disconnected. It is universal. Krishna consciousness is universal. Universal. You can connect it to Krishna as a yajna by just remembering him, offering that work to him. That is all. Now faith that if you surrender to him. And what does Krishna say? Tells Arjuna, Machitta Sarvadurgani Matprasada Tarishasi Atacheta Mahankara Nashosasi Vinanshasi. On the other hand, if you act out of Ahankara, that might be your free will. As per karma, you get the result. Nashosasi Vinanshasi. You will be lost in the world of karma. faith that if you surrender to him, he will take care of you. Sarvadharman parityaja mam ekam sharanam raja aham tam sarva papebhyo mokshishyam ma sucha. So you, I will be now in the module, just like the 16 points, these faith points on Krishna, that is faith points about Krishna and his holy name, faith points about, major faith points about Krishna consciousness, I will give with one sloka from Bhagavad Gita, and that you have to internalize, and that should become a bhavana, which most of the devotees are already having read Prabhupada's book, you are already having all these faiths, you are just being little more training our mind to faithfully chant. Apply that faith. You have faith at the philosophical level, it has to be applied. Faith that is all-pervading, supreme controller, Parameshwara. Faith that is a maintainer of the entire universe. Next. Faith that nothing moves without his sanction. Faith that he intervenes in devotees' lives to provide them with what they lack. It is not that after coming to Krishna consciousness, you know, there is no connection between my practical life and Krishna. Krishna and Goloka Vrindavan may not be connected to your day-to-day problem. But please remember, Paramatma is connected. Paramatma is in your heart for you and for your problems. So he intervenes. This is called God consciousness. The whole society can become God conscious. So as the Lord, he is God. Unlimited expansions. As Paramatma expansion, he is relating with all jivas who are in forgetfulness. Suddenly among them, some jivas start remembering him. He becomes their personal guide. He facilitates even your devotion service, because certain material circumstances makes it difficult to do devotion service. Is it not? So will not Krishna intervene with that? And he will protect you. He will give you an environment where you can chant Hare Krishna if you are serious. He will change your life situation. That faith you should have in him. Chanting Hare Krishna, Nama Prabhu will do everything. And you have to be patient. If he is not doing something, I have a lesson to learn. That is the meaning of faith. Faith is not simply, you know, when I get result. Faith you have to manifest when you don't get results. Krishna tests. In order to develop your faith, Krishna delays reciprocation. That should not be thing. See, faith in Krishna's protection is different. Krishna, expecting Krishna to be an order supplier of your desire is different. I have faith in the protection of the Lord. I have faith that the Lord will provide me. I have faith that the Lord will maintain me. These are not material desires. Because why? I have to practice Krishna consciousness. Therefore, this body has to be maintained. The body has to be protected. The way it has to be protected as he wishes. I don't dictate to him, protect me this way. I don't dictate to me, maintain me this way. Then you are making him an order supplier. What is his position? I do not want to disrespect Paramatma in my heart by making him order supplier. By Prabhupada's mercy, I have come to Krishna consciousness, where I know how to respect the Lord, how to pray I know. Not to pray for anything very specific like this and that. Of course, sometimes devotees are in very difficult, they don't pray, but they wish this trouble goes away. That is different from asking the Lord to remove the trouble. We are humans. We wish this trouble goes away, but I leave it to the will of the Lord. That should be the attitude of the devotee who has got faith. And if he is not reciprocating, patiently wait. To increase your level of faith, Krishna may make you wait. He is in control of everything. Now, in 1 second, he can take you out of your difficult situation. You may almost think, I am almost gone. I am fallen into the valley, right? Gone up to the edge and about to finish. My life is finished.
I wonder if she was requesting to repeat last 2 minutes in the lecture.
Yeah. Last 2 minutes.
Yeah. Faith is where Krishna seeks. See, Krishna wants to increase our faith in Him. Therefore, there's a difference between expecting Lord to reciprocate and having faith in His reciprocation. Faith in His reciprocation means He will reciprocate when, how, where. He is very much aware. Now you do material calculation. Oh, I am in such a great difficulty. I am not, you know, why Krishna is not protecting me? Oh, Krishna is not helping me. No, Krishna is just testing you. He is giving you the gift of higher faith. And you wait and wait. Krishna makes you wait and wait and wait. And because what is the use of solving your material problem immediately? What is a gift? It's a material gift. Is it not? If the Lord makes you wait and wait and wait and wait, and finally you are increasing your faith, you are not breaking your faith, you have faith. No, I have faith, Krishna has some reason. Why this is going on? Why this is going on? I have faith. So, Krishna is more interested in giving you an opportunity and an environment to increase your faith in Him. Just like the Pandavas. Pandavas got the gift of Krishna Bhakti. So similarly, we want everything connected, you know. As I said, we may pray to the Lord. We don't pray to the Lord specifically, but when difficulties come, especially for performing bhakti, material circumstances are very negative. We do desire that it goes away, but you don't make any specific you desire. And you're a devotee of the Lord. You don't have to make a written appeal to the Lord. He is seated in your heart. He reads. That is the faith you should have. The Lord knows my difficulty. And if my difficulty is not going, it is left to Him. But He will not let me down. I don't make what is the criterion of letting down. Oh, if this happened, He let me down. No, I don't say that. Hey, it is my tiny stupid intelligence is saying it is let me down. All good, all for good it is happening. And then the devotee goes on with his life. In his life he will see so many occasions, so many things. Becomes a blessing to remember that Krishna was always with me, never let me down. Every devotee will realize as he grows old, Krishna will never let you down. You have to be patient. Okay, so I stop today.
Thank you very much. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu Ki Jai.